or should I say, infamous disciple Judas. Do you know who Judas is?
Yes.
No, I do not know about Judas at all and who he is.
What do you remember about Judas? What did he do?
Betrayed Jesus by kissing him.
He killed Jesus.
Do you remember how Judas died?
No, I don't know anything about Judas.
No.
Judas killed himself.
Most people think Judas was bad.
She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
You see, Jesus was at table with all the disciples in what we call the Last Supper. And while he was there, he said that somebody at the table would betray him. Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss. Judas identified Jesus to the authorities so they could nab him and kill him, all by giving him a simple little kiss. They gave him a bag of silver in return. 50 pieces of silver for Jesus's life. So most people think Judas is the guy responsible for Jesus's death on the cross. And because of that, he had to pay for all of eternity. One story says that he's continually eaten by a gigantic monster who bites off his head over and over again through all of eternity, dying thousands of deaths over and over again as punishment for killing Jesus. He either felt so guilty, or he was so afraid of being killed by others, Judas killed himself. So, break it down for me. What do you think? Was Judas a good guy or a bad guy?
Bad.
He was good because he felt sad when Jesus died, actually, so he killed himself.
I have absolutely no idea how he died, how he survived, or what he is, or what he did, or if he was a criminal, or was a good guy.
What if Judas wasn't actually working against Jesus, but because of what he did, he was damned for all time because people believe that he was the worst betrayer of all? But what if I were to tell you that there's a gospel that says that Judas was not the betrayer at all, that he's not really the bad guy, that in fact, he's actually the good guy?
Really?
I know, right? Shocking. But in the gospel of Judas, it is Judas who is Jesus' confidant, Jesus' most beloved disciple. And that's because in this gospel, Jesus actually recruits Judas to be his partner to help carry out his plan. And in this gospel, it's clear that it's part of Jesus' plan that people will think that he has died on the cross, when in actuality, those that know that Jesus isn't dead at all, he lives. But Judas becomes a real superhero because for the rest of eternity, everybody thinks that he's the world's greatest betrayer, the worst betrayer of all, the worst guy who ever lived. That's why he has to suffer in Dante's Inferno. But in reality, for those who know, they know that Judas was actually working with Jesus, and he's the greatest superhero of all because he helped Jesus shed his mortal skin so he could shine. So, in a lot of ways, that feels pretty Jesus to me. Flipping the story upside down. The outsiders are in, the insiders are out. The ones who think we are bad are actually good. Jesus might have done it again.
That's how we keep it fresh.
That's how we keep it fresh.
How about this close to the camera?